Good morning. Today we have axially loaded column with uniaxial and biaxial bending. Now in this we have first part, that is axially loaded column with uniaxial bending, that is about any one of the axes, and second we have axially loaded column with biaxial bending, means we have bending about both axes or moment about both axes. Now you can see this problem, we can have analysis by equations, but that analysis is very complicated, and therefore IS code prefers interaction curves which are given in SP16 16. So in that one these curves are given, and by using these curves we can analyze columns, that is axially loaded column with uniaxial bending and axially loaded column with biaxial bending. So now what are these interaction curves and how we have to use these interaction curves to analyze and to design the problems, that we will see today. Now what is interaction curve? Interaction curve is a visual representation of bending moment mu, axial force pu, and the ratio of percentage of steel to characteristic strength of concrete. So we have p with the percentage of steel, and fck we have characteristic strength of concrete. This curve explains the ultimate capacity of the compression member when it is subjected to axial load and moment. Interaction diagram for rectangular and circular sections are available in SP16 1980 RC handbook. Limit state of method of design approach is adopted for the analysis of the work. Means these curves are by limit state method, or we can use it in the limit state method of design. Now you can see these curves. So how to select this curve? And there you can see this curve we can select, and what we require to select this curve. So you can see first Fy. So we have three values for characteristic strength of steel. That is first Fy, yield stress of steel, first Fy 250, Fy 415, and Fy 500. Second we have D dash by D. Now here you can see this value is given as 0.05. So we have these curves for D dash 0.05, 1, 1.5, and 2. So for these four values, we have curves, means first Fy3, then D dash by D4, and third we have these columns. So we have here steel which are on opposite faces. This is first type, and second type you can see we have steel on both sides. So you can see here we have steel on both sides, on all sides. Here steel on opposite side, that is only on two sides, whereas here we have steel on all sides. So we have first yield stress of steel, second D dash by D, and third steel on opposite faces or on all faces. Accordingly we have to decide which curves we have to select for analysis or design. Now axial, so we have two types of problem in this. So this is first axial load with uniaxial bending, first type. If pu is obtained to mu for given value of p by fck and the section, then select the appropriate chart D dash by D and draw a vertical line from the calculated value of mu upon fck bd square to cut the appropriate curve of p by fck. The ordinate of this point on y-axis gives pu upon fck bd or pu upon fck bd square, fck d square, because for circulars column we have only d, so that is pu upon fck d square for circular section from which pu can be obtained. Now if you will see in these curves, we have three values. Which are three values? One on x-axis I have mu upon fck bd square. If you calculate unit for this, then unit for this, that is non-dimensional, mu newton millimeter, fck newton per millimeter square, b millimeter, d square millimeter square. So this is non-dimensional. Go to pu upon fck bd, this is also newton and denominator is also newton, so this is also non-dimensional. So we have values of mu upon fck bd square on x-axis, pu upon fck bd on y-axis, and we have these all curves which are inside. These curves are of p by fck value. Now first curve we have 0, second 0.02, 0.04, 0.06. So likewise we have these curves for p by fck. Means in this we have three quantities, pu upon fck bd, mu upon fck bd square, and p by fck. Out of these three, if two quantities are given, then third quantity we can find. So that is one that is shown over here. So now you can see over here, analysis using this chart. So values are given of mu upon fck bd square and p by fck, and accordingly we have drawn a line from mu upon fck bd square which will cut your p by fck at point A, and then from point A we have drawn a line which is parallel to mu upon fck bd square which will cut your pu upon fck bd, and at point B, and knowing this value of pu upon fck bd, we are in position to find out value of pu. So any value you may have given, pu upon fck bd or p by fck bd, you can find mu upon fck bd square, or you have given pu upon fck bd and mu upon fck bd square, we can find p by fck. That means out of these three, if any two values are given, we are in position to find out the third value. Now we will go for the second case. In second case, if p by fck is given and e by d and the section are given, then we can solve this problem to calculate pu and mu. Now in this case, keep in mind what is given, p by fck is given and e by d is given. So e is eccentricity and we have d, that is depth. What is depth? Whichever axis or whichever dimension is cut or about which you are going to take the bending, that dimension is known as d. So sometimes it may be width. If your axis cuts the width, then your d will be b and b will be d. So which will be cut your dimension by the axis or about which you have bending, accordingly you have to consider value of d as b or d. So now in this case, p by fck is given, e by d is given, and we are interested to find out mu and pu. So now how we will solve this? Now you can see this. So we know mu upon fck bd square and pu upon fck bd. So if we will take a ratio of this, then we will get value of tan theta. Now tan theta, what mu we have pu into e, so what will remain? So we have e by d, that will be as tan theta. Now we can make it in denominator and numerator, numerator and denominator. So I will say e by d is numerator, so my denominator becomes 1. So that means we can take value of PU upon FCK BD as 1 and MU upon FCK BD square as E by D, and that will gives me a line. And if I will draw from that line, from that point, a vertical and horizontal line gives me PU upon FCK BD and MU upon FCK BD square. Now you can see this. So we have plotted 1. So 1 we have, that is the numerator, which is PU upon FCK BD. So I have plotted 1 over here. You can see here 1. Then MU upon FCK BD square, numerator is E by D, which is MU upon FCK BD square, which we have plotted over here. So now I know this value as 1. I know this value of E by D. I have drawn a line which is joining this. Or tan theta I can find by this value E by D, and then I can draw a line, and which will cut your line drawn from PU upon FCK BD at ordinate 1. So from this, so these values, we are in position to determine values of MU upon FCK BD square and PU upon FCK BD. Now we will go to second part, which is axial load with biaxial bending. So first we will cover theory for both, and then we will go for the problems. Now here, the resistance of member, this is given in clause number 39.6, IS 456-2000. The resistance of member subjected to axial force and biaxial bending, your this criteria should be satisfied. That is MUX upon MUX1 to the power alpha n, plus MUY upon MUY win to the power alpha n less than or equal to 1. Now MUX and MUY, these are the moment about X and Y axis due to design loads, and MUX1 and MUY win maximum uniaxial moment capacity, which is calculated from charts. Now alpha n, it is related with PU upon PUZ. Now PU, this is given value of load, and PUZ we have to find using this formula, which is capacity of the column with zero eccentricity. Now alpha n, how we will find? So these values are given, PU upon PUZ equal to 0.2 to 0.8. The value of alpha n vary linearly from 1 to 2, and for values alpha n less than 0.2 is 1, and for values greater than 0.8, 2. So it varies linearly between 0.2 to 0.8. So we can have this alpha n. So we have PU upon PUZ 0.2 to 0.8. So below 0.2 we have 1, and above 0.8 we have value as 2. So we have, this will be alpha n for different values of PU upon PUZ. Now we will go for the problem. First we will take problem that is uniaxial, and then we will go for the problem biaxial. Now design an uniaxial square short column. Square column we have by limit strip method with material M20 FE500 to carry ultimate load. So axial load is given ultimate, but moment is given working. So we have to make moment as working moment, and for ultimate moment we have to multiply it by 1.5. Now you can see this your bisect depth of the column. So now this is square column, so depth or width we have same value. The effective length of column is 3.6 meter. Now this is given, data FY is given, PU is given, MU we have multiplied by 1.5, so it comes 112.5 kilonewton meter. Then column short, so LE by B less than or equal to 12. Therefore, B should be greater than 3600 upon 12, which is 300 mm. So we have, as column is square, so we have side 300 millimeters. Now we have to consider steel on opposite faces. That is your choice. You can consider on all faces, or you can consider on opposite faces. So we have D dash. We have assume 50 millimeter, then we have D dash by D 50 upon 300, and then select from SP16 chart 37 for D dash by D equal to 0.15, and chart 38 for d dash by d 0.2. So now our value, this comes 0.167. So for this I have to interpolate between 1.5 and 0.2, and therefore we have to take two curves, then SP16, chart 37 and chart 38. So now we have this one. So now we have calculated PU upon FCKBD, and we have PU upon FCKBD as 0.5. Now MU upon FCKBD square, we got value of 0.21. We have to design, means we have to find out value of P by FCK. Knowing P by FCK, we can find steel. So out of three values, PU upon FCKBD, MU upon FCKBD square, and P by FCK, these two values are given. We have to find third value, which is P by FCK. So now draw the vertical line from the given value of MU upon FCKBD square, 0.21, and then draw a horizontal line from this point, which will intersect PU upon FCKBD. So now you can see this, we can see over here. So we have this curve. Now you can see what is D dash by D, 0.15, FY 500, and steel on opposite faces. So we have this chart number is 37. So now you can see, we have drawn line from MU upon FCKBD square 0.21. So you can see we have these values, 0.021, and PU upon FCKBD 0.5. So we have drawn these values, 0.2 vertical line and 0.5 horizontal line intersect at A, and this will give me value as 0.165. So we have this value as 0.165 because it is between 0.16 to 0.18. This is for D dash by D 0.15. Now in the same way I have calculated this value. Now here you can see this chart is for 0.2. So now here also I have drawn these lines, and this value gives me 0.175. So we have these two values. One is 0.165, second 0.175. And then we have interpolated this value for 0.15, 0.165, 0.2, 0.175, and for 0.167, this value comes 0.168. And from this, I will get value of P by FCK, and that value, which 0.168 we have over here, and for that P by FCK, we have calculated value of P, which is 3.36%. Now AAC we can find, that is 3.36 upon 100 into 300 into 300 gives 3024 mm square. So provide 4 bars of diameter 28 and 2 bars of 20 gives me value as 3091.33 mm square, which is given than the required. And then we have to provide lateral ties as usual. So same 1 by 6. Largest diameter. So while finding diameter of lateral ties, we have to take largest, and while finding pitch, we have to take smallest. So we have 1 by 6 or 6 mm, 4.67 or 6 mm. So diameter is 6. So we have minimum pitch, again least lateral dimension 300. Then we have smaller diameter 20, so 16 into 20, 320, and then 300. So provide 6 mm. Tor lateral ties at 300 mm center to center. While showing, you can see over here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. These are of 28 and 2 small are of 20. Now this is first problem where we have axially loaded column with uniaxial bending. In examination, we have one on this, one on biaxial, and one on axially loaded column. So now two we have covered. Now we will switch over to the third. Now third, you can see this is also exam problem. Last is also exam problem. Now here we have given working load 800, working moment 50 Pu, and My 25 kilonewton meter acting about axis, bisecting the depth and width of the column respectively. The effective length is given about X 4.5 meter and about Y axis is 3.5 meter. The unsupported length about both axis is 4 meters. M20 and FP415. Now, sorry, this is actually 900 kilonewton. So we have 1.5 into 900. So this comes 1350 kilonewtons. Now we have bending moment MX 55. So 1.5 into 55, 82.5. And 1.5 into 25, 37.5 kilonewton meter. This is actually not 800. This is 900 kilonewton. So now short column LEX by D less than or equal to 12. So D should be greater than 375. And for second, we have LEY by B less than or equal to 12. So B 291.67. So we have taken 300 by 450. Now why I have taken this 450? So actually I have taken it as 400, but your column is not safe and that value goes greater than 1 and therefore I have changed this value. So in examination, you go little bit on higher side, one of the dimensions or both dimensions. Here you can go this as 425, this as 325, then it's okay. So whatever dimensions you are getting, you go little bit higher side so that your values of moment, whatever you are going to get, these you will get on higher side because you have to multiply by BD square or B square D and automatically your MU X1 and MU Y1 increase, which are in denominator, so that your value come less than 1. So on higher side, you can go for these two values. So provide column 300 by 450. We have assumed D dash 50 millimeters. Now minimum moment. So these criteria are given again in IS code. So this should be your minimum moment. For that one, you have to check it. So we have unsupported length upon 500 plus D by 30. That value comes 23 millimeters. So we have to take maximum of 2 values which we have calculated and 20. So here we have taken E minimum X 23 millimeters. Similarly for E minimum Y, we have 4000 upon 500 plus 300 upon 30, which is less than 20. So we have to take 20. We have to take greater of the two values. So E minimum Y 20. So we have calculated MU minimum X and MU minimum Y. So we have to take maximum of value calculated and value given. So given in the problem. So we have PU into E minimum X. This comes 31.05 kilonewton meter. But this value is less than 82.5 kilonewton meter, which we have calculated already. So here you can see this value we have calculated as 82.5 and 37.5. So here also, this value comes 27, which is less than 37.5. So my value of MUX now 82.5 kilonewton meter and MUY 37.5 kilonewton meter. So we have to take maximum of the two in this case also. Now we have to assume percentage of steel in this case because here we have to check the capacity of the biaxial column. So try to understand the difference between the two. In first, we have three values, mu upon FCK BD, mu upon FCK BD square and P by FCK. Out of these two are given, we have to find third. But in this case, we have to find both mu X1, mu Y1 and we have given PU upon FCK BD. So we have to assume percentage of steel and then only we are in position to find out MU X1 and MU Y1. Because out of these three, we should know value two values. MU X and MU Y, these values are given, which are design loads. And MU X1 and MU Y1, these are the values calculated from the chart, which already we have seen in the problem. So now we will go for bending moment about XX axis. So when it will be bending moment about XX axis, means it bisects your depth of the column, which is 400 millimeter. So in this case, my D becomes 450 millimeter. But when I will go bending about YY axis, where my bisecting width, so there my D is 300 millimeter. So we should be careful, whichever dimension is bisected, that will be considered as depth of the column. So now here, curve has to select again. Fy is given 415. We have assumed D dash 50. So D dash by D, we have 0.11. So as it is 0.11, we have to take chart 0.1 and 0.15. PU upon FCK BD, again 0.5. P by FCK, we have taken 2% to 0.1. So now SP16, chart 32, D dash by D is 0.1. And for 33 chart, d dash by d is 0.15. Actually, this value for biaxial is taken as 1.5 to 2. Go little bit on higher side to save the column in examination. So that otherwise last, when our values are not coming less than 1, then that will be problem for us. We are not going to remember anything afterwards. So it is better always on higher side of the dimension, so that your value of mux upon mux1, that term should be less than 1, and that is with margin. So now here you can see we have value of 0.5. So I have value p upon fck 0.5, and I know p by fck 0.1. So I have drawn a line from 0.5, which is horizontal line, which is cutting this p by fck axis. So this is p by fck axis of 0.1. So it cuts p by fck at a, and from this I have drawn a vertical line which gives me mu upon fck bd square. So this value comes 0.11. So now you can go to second. So here you can see curve is 32, which is for 0.1. Now we can switch over to second curve, which is for 0.15. You can see chart 33, SP16, we have assumed steel on opposite faces. Now you can go here also 0.5, and this value comes 0.9. 0.5, we have drawn a horizontal line. Again, it cuts your P by FCK axis, this axis, at 0.1, and from which we have drawn a vertical line, which cuts my MU upon FCK BD square. This value comes 0.9. So we have, this value comes 1. So this is 1. So we have in first case 0.11, and in this case we have this value as 0.1. So we have 0.11 and 0.1, and we have calculated this value for 0.11 by interpolation of these two, gives me 0.108. It is very close to 0.1. So its value is also close to 0.1. So now from this I will get mu x1 upon fck bd square as 0.108, which will gives me value of mu x1. And this value of mu x1 I got as 131.22 kilonewton meter. This is value of mu x1. Now bending about yy axis, now keep in mind here my value that will be bisecting width of the column. So my width will be now 300. So I have d dash by d 0.167. So pu upon fck bd 0.5, p by fck 0.1. Now as this value is 0.167, so I have to take charge 33.15 and 0.234. So last time 0.15, we have chart number 37 and 38. That is for 500, and this is for 415. So now again we can go for this. So I have this chart, you can see chart 33, which is for d dash by d 0.15, fy 415, steel on opposite faces. Now in the same way we are going to plot it from 0.5, we are draw a horizontal line which will cut at p by fck 0.1. We will draw a vertical line from this, gives me value as 0.9. So in this way we can go for second also. Here also you can see, so this is for d dash by d 0.2, fy 415, and for this I will get again mu upon fck bd square. So for first we have this value as 0.1, and for second you can see value as 0.09. so for 0.167 we have calculated this value as 0.096. so now knowing this value, we are in position to find out mu y1. So mu y1 gives me value as 77.76 kilonewton meter. So we have these two values now, mu x1, mu y1. So now we have to find out alpha n, which is relates with your pu upon puz. So I have calculated value of puz. So we have assumed percentage of steel 2%. So I have this formula, 0.45 fck, 0.98 ag plus 0.75 fy, 0.02 ag. And from this I will get puz 2031.1 kilonewton, and from which I will get pu upon puz 0.66. I have calculated value of alpha n, we have seen there. So till till we have 0.2 value is 1, and from 0.2 to 0.8 it increases linearly, that is 1 to 2, and accordingly we have calculated alpha n, and this alpha n I got value as 1.77. Now we have substituted this value in this equation. So what value we have? Mu x upon mu x1 plus to the power alpha n plus mu y upon mu y1 to the power alpha n less than or equal to 1. Now you can see over here, so we have substituted these values, 82.5 divided by 131.22, which is mu x1, and this value alpha n we have calculated over here, 1.77 plus 37.5 upon 77.76 mu y, which is given, this 82.5 at 37.5, these are design moment, working load, ultimate moment, which are due to loads, and mu x1 and mu y1, these are from the charts. And by using this, my value comes 0.72, which is less than 1, therefore safe. Now ASC required, we have 2%, 2700 millimeter square. So we have provided 6 bars of 25 mm diameter. Now if we will find it, I got this value as 2945.24 mm square, which is greater than 2700 millimeter square. So this is most important when we will go for a biaxial moment. So if we will go through the question paper, many of the question paper you will come across this problem for 16 marks. Some problems you are with footing also, but in that they have asked to design till flexure only. But if you have biaxial column and then footing, then time required is more. So while selecting the question in the examination, you should be very careful which question we have to consider. We have 3 questions on this. Unit number 6, 1, axially loaded column with footing. Second, axially loaded with uniaxial moment with footing. Biaxial, axially loaded with biaxial moment. Sometimes only problem till this only. And sometimes you may have with footing only. So out of these you have to choose which problems are preferred in the examination so that we are in position to solve full question paper. So now last we have to go for lateral ties. As usual, class number we have 26.5.3.2c. So 1/6 into largest diameter. So again largest diameter we have here 1 only. So 1/6 of 25, 4.17 or 6 mm. Again whichever is greater. So we have to go for that. And then diameter of lateral ties, therefore we have to choose it at 6 millimeters. Now we can go pitch. Again we have 3 criteria for pitch. First criteria we have least lateral dimension. So we have 1 as 300, second 450. So least we have 300 millimeter. Second we have 16 into smallest diameter of longitudinal bar. So 16 into 25. So that comes 400 millimeter. And third we have 300 millimeters. So again we have to go minimum of the 3. And minimum of the 3 we have provide 6 millimeter torque lateral ties at 300 mm center to center. So we have these clauses which we have to use to provide lateral ties. So now we know cross section of the column. So we know area of steel of column and we know lateral ties. In this way, my designed column is in position to resist axial load, which is working load 900 kilonewton, and both moments which are given in x and y direction. So we have this problem which is for your axially loaded column with biaxial moment. So this is about your unit number 6 A part, which is column. So this completes your A part column, and next lecture we will go for the second part of this, that is footing. So tomorrow we will go for last lecture